All right, I want you to take a look at this intersection and memorize it. Lawrence and Hamilton, Borelli's a neighborhood staple here in the Ravenswood, Lincoln Square neighborhood. Something else coming into the neighborhood, but in the back part of that particular restaurant called Analog, Pizza and Video. And it is very much an old school video store, complete with VHS tapes, old school video games. You might know the gentleman who runs it. He has some work on Netflix called Drinking Buddies or Easy, Joe Swanberg. Yeah, it's that guy. He's got this video store, which is just right off the street here at Analog. So I'm gonna go and talk to Joe and see how this whole thing works for the Chicago scene. All right, so arcing back to like when we were kids, Joe, you've really like recreated some of the best memories, I think, of people of a certain age will remember, and it's the video store experience. So how awesome is that, man?
Very awesome. I mean, I started with my own personal collection, so it's obviously coming from my own deep connection to the video store. I worked at Hollywood Video in Naperville in high school, and I have a 10-year-old and a 5-year-old now who I don't think have ever been in a video store prior to this one, so...
Yeah, isn't that kind of sad when you think about it? Like, I mean, so for people who might not know, just tell us about your work that you've done where people might have seen it before, and then we get into the video store business here in a sec.
Sure. Well, I'm a Chicago independent filmmaker. I think my most well-known movie is called Drinking Buddies. I also made one called Happy Christmas that a lot of people have seen. And then I made a Netflix series called Easy, which we made here in Chicago from 2015 to 2018. And I've also made like 17 other super low-budget independent films.
So it's safe to say that you love movies and you love the movie-making process or just a storytelling process. And I feel like a video store in itself is a story just because when I'm guessing we're pretty close in age. So I mean, going to the video store when we were kids, you either ride your bike there, your parents dropped you off, and you spent a good solid hour sometimes picking out a movie, or if you're really lucky and they put it on hold for you, you scoop that one up and you're on your way home. But that's kind of where this idea to bring it back came from, right?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, we're non-searchable. I mean, this entire experience is an analog experience. All of our membership information is kept on paper and pencil with a little card box. Membership cards involve this old Polaroid camera.
Yeah, I mean, which is right
like here. Laminated actual membership cards, and I'm doing the entire experience as if it was 1998 or something like that.
And the experience is, everything in here is analog, like you said, you know, with the Polaroid cameras, you even had some video games, and you get to do the thing that you haven't done in years, where you could walk and just go down the shelves and find movies that you probably haven't seen in years, or you have seen in years if you got the digital copy, but I feel like that's sacrilegious. Even me shooting this on a, what I'm shooting it on now here digitally, I don't want you to be upset with me, but this is the way we do it now, but it's a great way to tell your story. So this is amazing, so thank you.
Yeah, I think browsing, the process of browsing and the experience of browsing is really different online. Obviously, the internet has allowed a lot of new tools, the flow of information in all kinds of new ways. But the experience of like picking up a box, turning it over, reading a description, sort of getting to compare and contrast in that way is increasingly disappearing even from streaming platforms, you know, like increasingly the old platforms used to feel a lot like a video store, just like big tiles of boxes. But it's such an interactive experience now that when I try and browse on a streaming platform, it's like playing things at me. It's starting movies before I've even chosen them.
You almost want to shush it.
It's like a schizophrenic experience now where I'm kind of like, I am just trying to look at art and read a paragraph description. Like, leave me alone.
Yeah, especially when you're talking about old movies. I just talked about like The Howling 2, which is a movie from back in the day. But the cover is what grabs you, you know, when you're walking through a video store, or even like Tales from the Crypt or any of those old school movies, Fast Times at Ridgemont High.
Yeah.
Basically, all like the movie posters that we had in our rooms in high school and in college, you know, that's what you want to do. So this is similar, I would say, maybe to like going to a record store, would you say? Without the digital stuff, but just the vinyl searching.
Yeah, and also like aesthetics are cyclical. Like the artwork on these VHS boxes was very hip and modern at the time. I mean, these companies were obviously trying to hire the coolest designers and create things that were very appealing. Then they went out of style. Now they're coming back into style. So I feel like the artwork here is really cool looking. It's handmade, You know, sort of early Photoshop or pre-Photoshop, a lot of just design styles and ideas that were sort of like reaching the crest of another wave of interest in. So it's fun to see them all kind of spread around like this.
Yeah, for sure. And I would imagine that the finding them is the fun part for you, or the hard part. I don't know. Is it hard to find these old tapes? And I mean, you got like a whole storage locker of, or cabinet rather, of VHS. Let me swing around. Why not? Because this is how we do these. So this is like the collection right now. Like this is what used to, like, with the guy at the video store would disappear behind the wall and then magically get your tape out, right? Like this is the...
All of our hand labeled. And then when stuff gets rented, the box gets put in here. You see which member rented it, and
very cool.
Kind of keep track of our system that way.
Yeah, I'm gonna hang out here for a second. So, do you accept new videotapes from customers? I mean, how does that work for you?
Yeah, I've been scouring eBay and talking to other collectors. Also, several people have just brought in like big bags or boxes of videos. Like now that the store is up, I've gotten a lot of donations and just kind of friend support from people who are like, I don't even own a VCR anymore. You can have all of these. So the collection's now made up a mishmash of like my personal collection of around 250 that we started with, and now new things that I bought since I opened, and donations and other things.
So I noticed it's $80 a year cash for a video store membership, and it's two unlimited rentals, but two at a time, right? And that's how it works. And for people who are not familiar with this spot, how do you recommend them coming in? Should they go through the, I mean, we haven't even talked about that. This is ducked back in a pizza parlor, like old school pizza parlor here in Chicago, right off of Lawrence Avenue, right?
Yeah. Yeah. If anybody wants to come in, they can enter on the side underneath the analog sign, or they can come right in through the front door of Borelli's. We're open Thursday, Friday, Saturday from 8 to 1 in the morning. And the membership is sort of borrowing the best aspect of streaming, which is that you pay by the month or you pay by the year, and then you can kind of watch movies as you feel. I'm getting rid of late fees, I'm getting rid of rewind fees and all of those old components of the video store, and I'm just doing a straight up $80 a year, rent as many movies as you want, keep them for as long as you want. If someone wants to rent two VHSs and keep them for 3 months, that's up to them. We're seeing all kinds of things. Like some people signed up the first weekend and I haven't seen them for 6 weeks now. Other people have already been back in here 5 times renting 2 movies every single weekend. So just like the old days, it's kind of back to people's personal habits.
Very cool. And you're not online, and that's what you pride yourself on. So if people want to come here, they got to come here, which is right off of Lawrence. What's the cross street right here that we're on a sign up?
We're at the corner. We are at the corner of Lawrence and Hamilton in Lincoln Square. And yeah, there's no website. There's no social media. There's no telephone number.
I have no idea how I found you, but I did, which I'm very happy about. And it's been a pleasure talking to you. And, there's a lot of people who I told this about, and they just absolutely love the idea. So I wish you nothing but the best. I hope the people return the movies at some point so other people can rent them. So if they're watching this now, hopefully they will know what to do. No hard feelings, just return them, right? And rewind it.
Yeah, that's right. Rewind, but also... No sweat if you don't. We can take care of that here at the store.
Awesome. Well, thanks a lot, Joe. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Yeah. All right, that's the scoop on Analog Pizza and Video Store. Living up very much to that name. Everything in there is not digital, all analog. Pretty awesome. TBARNAS at WGNTV.com. If you have a suggestion for the Chicago scene, that's TBARNAS at WGNTV.com. And a quick hint for you. There's Borelli's. That's Lawrence Avenue. You just come right in. You walk down the sidewalk. Analog Pizza and Video. There you go.